This is a crime the city and a wailing stagnation among the people. For behold, the darkness covers the earth and gross darkness the people. But this is a people robbed and spoiled. They are all of them snared in holes and they are laid in prison houses. They are for a prey and none safe restore. Suddenly, comes a light and form of a word as a man to God's servant saying,
listen to me. 2017 was or could be a year of turbulence for you. But 2018 will be a year of peace for you. I want us to enter into a covenant of peace. It's our year of covenant. So you will be hearing more and more of the covenant this year. Because whatever God will do, it will be from the covenant he has made with you. What is the covenant? It's an agenda. Agenda between two people. Agreement between two people that cannot be broken. So God said 2018, there is an agenda that cannot be broken. So we'll be opening those agenda one by one, month by month. And one of those agenda of the year is the agendas of peace. Hallelujah. The covenant of peace. Amen. From where our pastor read in the morning, I'm going to go there, one before there. Acts chapter 3 verse 25. Acts chapter 3 verse 25. We are going to be opening covenant agenda. Covenant agenda every Sunday. Ye are the children of the prophet and of the covenant which God made with our fathers, saying unto Abraham, in thy seed shall all the kindreds of the earth be blessed. Ye are the children of the prophet. The truth of the matter is this: whether you like it or you believe it, only a fool doubt a proof. I am one of the accredited prophets, and I am glad that you are here. And we are both sons and daughters of the Abraham, and therefore we are operating under the Abrahamic covenant. Ye are children of the prophets, and we are all under the covenant of our fathers, Father Abraham. Can I quickly show you some of the Abrahamic covenant that we will be unraveling this year? We will be opening this year. Studio, display them one by one. We'll be looking at the covenant, the supernatural covenant. 4, we'll be looking at provision covenant. 5, we'll be looking at supernatural protection covenant. What does that mean? We are going to be under the covenant protection. Nobody will lose anything this year. Nobody will be buried this year. We'll be looking at supernatural greatness covenant. Number 7, we'll be looking at supernatural reward covenant. And we'll be looking at supernatural nations and the land covenant. Also, we'll be looking at supernatural prophetic revelation covenant. That is one of those covenants that the word of knowledge, the word of prophecy, the word that concerns nation, the word that concerns individual, God will be confirming the word of his servant. God will be what? Confirming every word of his servant. Every word that I will speak to every one of you, even if it is not in your life agenda, the moment I speak to it, it has become a reality. Supernatural prophetic revelation covenant. Like what I speak to this sister now, look at her right now. In the next few weeks, you begin to see her sharing the testimony. Look at this brother now. In the next few months, he begin to share his testimony. Prophetic revelation covenant. Then we'll be looking at supernatural speed covenant. And then we'll also be looking at the supernatural boldness covenant. And then we'll be looking at supernatural peace covenant. How many of these covenants? Even if you take all of this one by one, 2018 is a walkthrough year for you. If you operate under that 12 covenant. So I'm taking a quick note on the supernatural peace covenant. This 2018 is your year of peace. Amen. Tell your neighbor, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Say neighbor.
Neighbor.
Relax.
Relax.
Tell your neighbor, neighbor.
Neighbor.
By what we spoke last year.
By what we spoke last year.
This year is your year of peace.
Is your year of peace.
Tell neighbor, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Remember what you told me yesterday.
Remember what you told me yesterday.
This year. To be year of peace.
To be year of peace.
Now, I'll show you something right now. God will be giving us peace this year in businesses, in career, in relationship. There are many people under the sound of my voice right now that are out of peace. They're what? There are many people, both the people under the sound of my voice on the internet, on YouTube, that are out of peace. How can you start a year when you are out of peace? What can bring that? A lot of people are already afraid of 2018. The Lord said to me, go and tell my people, and we enter into a covenant of peace with them. Therefore, what was a turbulent situation last year will be the year of testimony in this covenant year of peace.
Amen.
So I want to quickly show you how can I enter into a covenant of peace? People of God, whatever that cannot give you peace, whatever that does not give you peace, has the ability to pieces you. Do you hear what I said? Say, neighbor. Talk to your talk. Neighbor, whatever does not give you peace can pieces you. It's simple as that. How many of you believe that? How many of you believe that? Whatever that does not give you peace, it has the capacity to pieces you. Say, but this year, it will be my year of peace. I see many people, they are not having peace in their career, in their business, in education, in family, in relationship, and their heart are already tearing into pieces. After this service, my God will gather all your pieces.
Yes,
step forth your hand. I speak to you.
I receive
every pieces that the enemy and the world has given to you.
Jesus.
Will be gathered together today.
Amen.
For your peace.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Whatever that cannot give you peace can turn you to pieces. Now, this is the solution. Is there anything that is giving you unpeace? Is there anything that is making you unpeace? This is the solution. Enter into the covenant of peace with God. Ezekiel chapter 37, where the man of God read for us this morning. Ezekiel chapter 37, verse 26. He said, moreover, I will make a covenant of peace with them. It shall be an everlasting covenant with them. And I will bless them. And I will multiply them. I will bless them. I will multiply them. You have been displaced 2017. And that's why you don't have peace. You have what? You have been displaced 2017. And that's why there was no peace. But 2018, the Lord said, I will make a covenant of peace. And then I will what? I will place you. When I place you, I will not leave you there. But I will what? I will multiply you. Say, that is me.
That is me.
Say, that is me.
That is me.
Whatever that have pieces you, God say he will place you with your peace this year. And he will what? He will multiply you. And he will set my sanctuary. And I will set my sanctuary in the midst of them forever. Listen to me. There is one solution to your peace this year. The sanctuary of God. The sanctuary of God. The sanctuary of God. Do not take your peace at your work. You did it last year, it failed. Do not place your peace at your friends, at your neighbor, at your husband, at your wife, at your chummy. Your peace, sanctuary. And where is the sanctuary? The altars of God. And that's where I'm going to be talking right now. How can I take my peace into the altars of the Lord? Leviticus chapter 24, verse 8. Leviticus 24, verse 8 says, every Sabbath, he shall set it in order before the Lord continually, being taken from the children of Israel by an everlasting covenant. Every Sabbath, the Lord will be renewing your peace. Every Sunday, the Lord will be renewing your peace. Every service time, the Lord will be renewing your peace. Please, people of God, don't take altars of God for granted this year. Don't take your fellowship with God for granted this year. They are lying your peace. Numbers chapter 25, verse 12. I speak to somebody under the sound of my voice. Whatever that has caused you or that has taken away your peace so many years, they shall bring back to you peace this year. We have all said before, behold, I give unto him my covenant of peace. Quickly, people of the Lord, how can I enter into a covenant of peace? How can I enter into a covenant of peace? There are two ways to it. I want you to declare yourself and declare a covenant with the Lord. That Lord, this year, you are my only God of peace. I want you to put all your cares, your body, unto the Lord. Your cares, your worries, unto the Lord. By your faith. Declare a covenant. After declaring a covenant, now, God asked me to give you some instruction. Some instruction that will give you peace. Some instruction. Number one, how can you enter into 2018 peace? This is the foundations of the year. I don't want you to do everything carelessly anymore. If you want to have peace, this is number one. Be realistic. Make a realistic target for the year 2018. Even when you are operating in faith, this brings me to the fact that every one of you that have not dropped your covenant, that has not dropped your prayer expectation for 2018, please, you still have time to drop it because we are still going to pray to the Ark of the Covenant. This year, for all of you that have dropped your prayer request, expectation, are you realistic? Some of you, your prayer expectation, is it realistic? Hello? Because if your expectation or your plan is does not even make sense to you, you will just be there till December. Nothing may happen. Because it's not realistic. For example, last year, December, somebody sent me a message. And I showed it to some of us. He said, Father, I'm going to donate to the ministry. Helicopter. He said, I'm going to delay to the ministry. Helicopter. I said, Early what? Helicopter. That is a very sad, nice agenda, but is it realistic? Now, Father, the helicopter is en route. So they need a certain amount to clear it. First, number one, before you take my peace, I've already He said, it's in my SMS. I will have shown it to you. He said, this is the helicopter I want to deliver to church after the fasting. After the fasting. Even the person knows that we are fasting. The church, you don't know the church, oh. Those is my daughter. But you don't know the church, oh. Those is very rich, but she doesn't know our church, oh. She's very rich. That's it, the truth. Very, very rich. But I am being realistic to myself. Even if you give me the helicopter, am I going to take Sandra to Ghana with the helicopter? Eh? Where is the hangar that I'm going to put it? Eh? Where is the hangar? I said, you know what? The helicopter I'm using right now is okay for the church. You know, I am being what? Realistic. I'm being what?
Realistic.
Some of your decisions for 2019, they are not realistic. Even though I told you before, I said you need faith. The kind of faith I'm talking about must go along with reality. With what? Reality. Don't do anything out of reality. Don't pursue any van project that will take peace away from you. You are not being realistic. Hello?
Hi.
I told my daughter, hey, be realistic. Be what? Be realistic. You want to go to Cape Town? Be realistic. You want to go to Eastern Cape? Be realistic. And then our sense come home. It's true. If you are not realistic, you will come home once in a year. And even when you want to come once in a year, you will go by a Kelechi bus. I won't be buying you flight ticket. Eh? You what? Be realistic. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, be realistic. I want to get married. Okay, it's a good thing. And I'm praying that I will get all of you married this year. But are you being realistic to yourself? Are you a wife material? Are you a wife material?
Husband material.
Show me your salary. Show me your bed. You don't even have bed. You say you want to marry. Go and buy bed. After you buy bed, nice bed. Okay? Go and buy pot. Eh? Queen size. That will carry two people. Not the small one you are using now for one person. And you want to take two people there. You are not realistic. I ask you to use faith. I will be happy when I see you preparing like me, preparing a place where you'll be sending sweet and biscuit. I will be happy when I see you go and buy mealy-me. And I say, what do you want to do with this mealy-me? You say, I want to be sending it in Alexander. I now know that you are facing reality. But when I come to your house, I say, what are you doing? You say, I'm sleeping. Daddy, Papa, I'm sleeping. I said, what are you waiting for? I'm waiting for the SMS. And you are waiting for the SMS. And you want to get married this year. I will just say, receive it in Jesus' name. What you receive is what? You know it yourself. Be realistic. Don't pursue project that will kill you. That is above your capacity. There are certain projects that I cannot embark on. If I embark on that, I want to buy a helicopter, or I want to take that my daughter helicopter. Am I being realistic? Am I being realistic? And now I'm also not saying, oh God, give me a helicopter, give me a, instead of me to say, oh God, give me sort of bus that I will be using. I mean, be realistic. Otherwise, it will take away your peace. God of peace. God is ready to give you peace. But have you also prepared for this peace? Hello? Be realistic. Even when you operate in faith. Number two. Let's read it together. Don't be a fool this year. And don't fool yourself. Even if you fool others, don't fool yourself. Tell your neighbor. Say, neighbor. Don't be a fool this year. Even if you fool yourself. Even if you fool others. Say, even if you fool me. Tell your neighbor very well. Tell your neighbor. Let them hear. Say, neighbor, if you fool me, don't fool yourself.
Don't fool yourself.
Because among two people, we know who is fooling each other.
Yes.
If I don't know that you are fooling me, you know you are fooling yourself.
Yes, sir.
If you fool other people, which is allowed, you can fool any other person. It's allowed. Hello? Since they give themselves to be fooled. You can fool others, so, but please don't fool yourself. Hello? After you finish, say, fool me. When you fool me, when you go back inside the room, don't fool yourself. You must speak to yourself. Hey, my friend, that thing you tell Papa, it's not the truth, though. So do the right thing. Don't fool yourself. Hello? Hey, you can fool anybody, oh. You can fool anybody. But don't fool yourself. Fooling yourself will disallow you to face reality. You can fool yourself. After you put on the nice dress and everything, where are you coming from? I'm coming from the work. Which work? You better tell the person, I'm just walking around, though. Help me. You are going to that brother, you are going to that sister. And you are going with your swag. Hi, baby. How you doing? I've been looking to see you. Where you been? I'm happy to meet you today. Where are you coming from? I'm just coming from the work. Which work? You better tell her, Sissy, I just dressed to come and see you. I don't have work. And you don't know that you are talking to human resources manager that is looking for somebody to employ. If you fool me, don't fool yourself, my friend. Otherwise, it will take away your peace. Because you have told us. Now, you are sitting there in Madonna. Oh, yeah, by Madonna. You don't have sense. Double wahala. Number three. Set out your house in order. What? Set out your house in order. If you want to have peace, put everything in order from now. Have a target. Have an agenda that by March, by February, if I don't get this job, if I don't get this appointment, I think I better go and learn how to do salon. Set out your house in order right now. If you don't set out your house in order, other people will set it for you. And they will set the wrong thing for you because they don't know your agenda. If I'm setting an agenda, if I'm setting a plan for you right now, by January, you will go to Pomolanga, correct. By March, you will go to Malawi, correct. You will go to Malawi. Do you have passport? And you are saying, correct. Correct. Hey, put your house in order. Go and get passport. Hey, the Lord will bless you this year. You are going to America. You are going to United Kingdom. Do you have permit? If you will buy a car this year, I prophesy to you, you buy a car. Last year, you failed your learner license. And now you are not going there again. You are put your house in order now. Eda. That's your boy. That's your girl. He's hearing me now. Last year, he failed learner. Instead of going back to learner now this January, he says not going. And me, I'm prophesying you will buy your car. What would you use to buy your car? Is it not license? Put your house in. Maybe I'm just speaking. Oh, mommy, did any one of you do Lena? Yes. She did Lena last year. I was just speaking. You did Lena. Who is that one? Stand up. I'm just speaking by prophecy. You did Lena last year. You pass. Come and give her the clap offering. Now you are being realistic. Have you gone for your license? Yeah. You have gone. You have it. You have your license. Where is it? It's at home. Okay. Can I speak to your life? This year,
prophesy.
You are buying your car.
Amen.
That is what I mean by being realistic. Being what? Being realistic. That's a typical example of what I'm talking about. Set your house in order. Otherwise, you will be disorder. You be what? You will be disorders. And the world will put you to order. It's better you put your house in order before they put you to order. Number four. My time is well spent, but I want to deliver this word for you quickly. Number four, set your heart in priority. What? Set your heart in priority. If you don't have a house, why do you want to buy a car? Where are you going to park it? You are still living now in somewhere that is not secure. The day you bring that car home, the day it will disappear. Because you didn't think about set your heart in priority. Priority. Which one is important to your life right now? Is it marriage that is important to your life right now, or is it a job? Is it the job that is important to your life now, or is it what? Is it now time? Is it now? So as I'm speaking right now, is it the time for you to go and say you want to go and rent a house in Santi? If you can rent a house in Alexandria and it will give you a small yard where you can park your car, set your heart in priority. Eh? Don't do this thing the way you did it last year. If you don't set your house in priority, you will lose your dignity. Set your heart in priority. It is because you didn't set your heart in priority, that's why you carry your bag and everything. You say you are going to Cape Town to Table Mountain. To go and do what? There is a Table Mountain in Mati Kasilo or in God Reefs there. Go there. That's where you can do now. Set your house in priority. Why do you have to buy 4x4 if you can use a small one? Who are you trying to impress? Set your heart in priority. Number five. Know your level and your capacity. What? This year, know your level and know your capacity. Even if you are operating in faith, there are levels in life. Know what? Know your level and your capacity. Don't do above your level. Don't do above your capacity. If you attempt to do above your level and your capacity, it will take away your peace. It's not a cause. You have caused this peace for yourself. And then, I don't care whatever you said about me, whether you like it and say, hey, everybody is riding jeep bike, everybody is flying now. If I can't fly, I will go by road. Know your level and your capacity. If I can't buy in Edgar's, I will go to Pick and Pay and buy. If I can't buy in Pick and Pay, I will go to Bend Down Boutique and bend down and pick it. Know your level and capacity. Don't operate on another person's level. You are going to live a fake life. Don't look at somebody's Brazilian hair and say you also want to wear Brazilian hair next Sunday. By the time you attempt it, you will end up here in Ghana here or Mozambique here. Know your level and your capacity. The fact that you visit your friend and your friend is doing something different now and you also say you want to go there. Is that your level? You will get frustrated there if it's not your level. Hello? As you see me in this, I know my level. That's the truth. As you see me, no matter how big men of God that I follow, no matter how, when you see me under those people, I know my level. I just sit down gently and I say, Papa, when I come here, you can call me Papa. But when I go to there, I also say, Papa, why? I know my level. I know what I want to get. I don't go there and be saying, and then put bodyguard by myself also. So that they can, I know you will miss your things there. Know your level. My wife know me. My wife say, who is this one? I say, Papa. Ah, Papa indeed. I say, I beg, leave me. I know my level. Know your level and your capacity. Hello? Number 6. Do not be afraid of big dream. You hear me? Do not be afraid. But be more realistic, both in your faith and in your work. I'm not saying all of this is to scare you. Do not be afraid of big dream, but be more realistic. It will be insane of me, it will be insane of the highest order, and now say, I'm going to go and contest for ANC municipality. It's a big dream. I want to be a big man. But is that where my dream is supposed to go? Be more realistic. I would rather go back to our village and say I want to take a position for councillor. Councillor, not even as a chairman. Do not be afraid of big dream, but be more realistic about it. Am I making sense to you? Even if it does not make sense to you, it's making sense to me. That's why I said before, even if I'm fooling you, I'm not fooling myself. It's applied to everybody. Even if I'm standing on this altar, hear me, and I'm fooling all of you, I know myself. Are you getting me? I know what I'm doing. I can fool all of you, but hey, Wena, I know. In my secret place, in my office, in my house, I know what I'm doing. So if you fool every other person, hey, don't fool yourself. You better go and find a solution to yourself. Okay, fine. Good word. But I'm not. Go and find a solution to yourself the following day. Now, number 7. Be meek. Be what? Be meek. Let's read Psalm 37 verse 11. Say, but the meek shall inherit the earth, and shall delight themselves in the abundance of peace. Let's read it together. Let's read it together. Want to go? And shall delight themselves in the abundance of peace. You want to have peace this year? I have one secret for you. Be meek. What is be meek? Be meek. Meekness. Meekness. Be humble. Be humble. Your last year arrogancy is what brings this peace in your life. You want to continue with same arrogancy this year? Congratulations. Well done. Well done. Be what? Be meek. Tell your neighbor. Neighbor, be meek. Stop your. Tell your neighbor. Say, neighbor, stop your arrogancy. To me, and be meek. Be humble. Two of you speak. Speak to yourself. Speak to your neighbor. Say, neighbor, be meek. Stop your arrogancy. Be humble to me. Because even it starts from church. When you cannot be humble to your friend. But I won't be surprised when you get outside. When you underrate the person that you are seated by now, and you are looking down on her, you are looking down on him, you are saying, right now you are just waiting for me to finish the service so that you can take your chair or go and say, be meek. What did you wear that nobody has ever wear? Is it not this thing you bought at the Pick and Pay? You are now arrogancy. Be meek. Anywhere you go to a business meeting, humble yourself. Don't look down and there and say, what are these people doing? Me, a celebrity. Me. Be what? Be meek. Don't carry your PhD title to the church. Don't carry your PhD title to the office. Be what? Be meek. That's where the abundance of peace. Look at me. I'm a man of peace. You like? Step on my toes. I will say sorry. You are the one that step on my toes, but I will still tell you, I'm sorry that you step on my toes. No wahala. There will be no fighting. So, this idea of you are cross. Some people come to church now and they still go back home cross without peace. Does it make sense? Eh? You came with mountains of problem. You now go on with another mountains of trouble. You don't have peace. So many marriages, so many relationships now. Some of my daughters or my sister here, the reason why there is no peace is because they don't know how to be humble. Humble. Tell that person, tell that brother, tell that husband, tell your wife, tell your husband, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Instead of waiting for, I don't know what he's going to do now when he comes. Oh, I don't know what he's going to do when I go back home. Oh, maybe he's going to kill me. Oh, I'm in trouble. Oh, sort out yourself before you go home. I'm sorry, baby. Uh-huh. Then you have peace. Be what? Be meek. Humble yourself. Humble yourself this year. Come down from your high horses this year. And there will be what? There will be peace. Number 8. I'm always standing up. Ensure your packaging to be perfect. Do everything in perfect order. This year, do everything in perfect order. Businessmen, businesswoman, please change your approach. Change your approach. Repackage your business. Go and repackage your CV. You have been sending one CV for the past 3 years. Go and repackage it. That's where you are getting the same result. They are rejecting you. Go and repackage the CV. Eh? If you need to change your email, maybe your email is not good enough. Go and change it. Packaging. Your office, your business, package it. Go in your house, even right now, go and change some furniture. Reposition them for 2018. Packaging. Eh? Put pillows. Put. Yeah. If you are doing your low cut last year and nobody likes low cut, allow the natural hair to grow this year. If the natural hair is not working well last year, put money together for Brazilian hair. It's fight faster. Eh? Sometimes look natural. Maybe somebody is looking for natural. Sometimes you can stop using the foundation and use a natural foundation. Mm-hmm. Maybe that is what some guys want around your environment. If you like to leave a flow like this, leave it. If you like to do Chisco, if maybe that is just by enemy, repackage yourself. Not from the worst, but from worst to the bad to good. Not from good to worst. Hello? Repackage. Do everything in perfect order. Repackage the way you talk to your customer. Your big mouth. Customer say, I don't like this thing. You say, if you don't like it, give it to me. You will take it, but you will never come there. Repackage yourself. Repackage your talking. The way you talk, repackage it this year. The way you curse people, the way you abuse people, reduce it this year. Just small. It will help. Just small. The way you shout at people, reduce it this year. It's part of repackaging. Hello? Repackage yourself. You understand what I mean, every one of you? You understand what I mean? Even at home, husband and wife, repackage your kitchen. This pap, you are giving to this man. That's why he's getting too much energy to beat you. Reduce it to reduce it to salad. Repackage your home. Repackage your dressing. Look at Mama Tawu now repackaging. I need to make you to laugh. Repackaging. Don't wear the same thing you are wearing last year like a Magogo. Every time you are going to interview, you are dressing like a SU. You know what I mean by SU? You're just like Genesis people. You're just like, And if you are dressing like my osa before, you change your packaging to a church person this time around. Perhaps you will see brother here that way. It's because the reason why they've not talking to you is the way you are dressing last year. You are dressing like a Mahosa. You know what I mean by Mahosa? Let's use the word so that they can hear now. You are dressing like somebody going to club. That's why they don't talk to you. That's why they are looking for somebody in the church. Somebody say if you want a good wife, go to church. If you want a good brother, go to church. You are in church now. Repackage yourself. Am I making sense to you? Let's read it. Psalm 37. He said, mark the perfect man and behold the upright, for the end of that man is peace. A what? A perfect man. And perfect come by packaging. Hello? My time is well spent. Please, God help me. And I want to deliver this thing for you. Number 9, avoid trouble this year. Avoid trouble. Home trouble, government trouble, friends trouble, avoid it. You want to have peace this year? Not like last year? Avoid trouble. Tell your neighbor, avoid my trouble. If you want peace this year, say it to another person. Say, neighbor, avoid my trouble this year. If you want peace, don't take people for granted anymore. You are taking that guy, that person for granted too much. And you are looking for a trouble. You look for his trouble. That's why you find that trouble. That's why nobody is good to you. Mr. B is not good. Mrs. B is not good. Mrs. A is not good. Because you look for trouble. You are a troublemaker yourself. You are a big troublemaker. Your friend is not tolerating you. And that's why you think every time you don't have peace. Why? Because you are a troublemaker. You are a troublemaker. Avoid trouble, please. Make peace with people this year. Don't show that you are a tiger. Don't show that I will show you that I'm a karate. I was trained for karate. If I stop going to that karate this year. Somebody, because you want to show us that you gym, and now you want to demonstrate your muscle. All my guys here, you are hearing me. You want to show your muscle. I will beat you. You are a troublemaker. Well, now you are a troublemaker. And that's why you don't have peace. That's why everybody is rejecting you. All the boyfriend, all the girlfriend you have been approaching since 2018, 17. Where are they? You are a troublemaker. You can't get one to say, I do. Because you are a troublemaker. Say, Lord. Say, oh Lord, deliver me from being a troublemaker. Because some of you are troublemakers. You even make trouble at home. Small thing, you make trouble with your husband. Small thing, you make trouble with your wife. Small thing, you make trouble with your friend. Now only you are kako. Say this year, I will avoid trouble. Tell your neighbor, forgive me. Any trouble I've given you last year, this year, I'm a changed person. Even right now. Don't worry, it's remaining that I will close the service. Take a quick decision. Number 10, let's read it together. One, two, go. Take a quick decision that will help your action. Because an action without a decision is an illusion. And delusion. Read it again. Take a quick decision that will help your action. Because an action without a decision is an illusion and delusion. Can I tell you what that means? Take a quick decision. Now that you have said, I will avoid trouble, take a decision. Because you can keep talking that I want to avoid trouble without taking a decision. It's an illusion. You are just talking for Yeah, just open your mouth. Take a decision. Until when you take a decision, that's when I know that you have taken an action. Let me read this one so that you can understand it. 11. Let's read it together. 11. Studio. Let's show that these two will take. Oh yeah, let's do. One, two, go. Take precise action now on whatever that has not been working for 1 year. Avoid religious sentiment in the name of faith and hope. I'll put that together for you now. Take action. It is your action that will showcase your decision. There is no decision that materializes without an action. You have taken a decision now. I won't go to that place anymore. You're just talking. In fact, as you are talking now, I'm doing this like this to you. He's talking. Look at him talking. It is your action that will show me your decision. Did I see every one of you now? Did I see your decision? Did I know what is in your heart? Did I know what you are deciding? Even if you are planning out to kill me, I don't know. But the moment I see gun in your hand, I will run. Because I know that is your action. It is your action that will determine your decision. I will further my education. And you are seated in one position. I will believe you when I see you filling a form. And you brought a form for me. But you are telling me, Papa, please give me 50 rand. Give me 50,000. I want to further my education. I won't give you 5 rand. Because I know that you are playing me. But when I see your action, I will be prompted to support. It's like that everywhere. Your action is what determines your what? Your decision. Because your decision without an action is an illusion and delusion. It will frustrate and it will take peace. So many people could have been well settled today. They keep desiring, but they are not putting action. And that's why there is no peace. So that will not happen 2018. That's why I'm saying it right now. I'm writing up now. Verse 10. 10. Have peace with God when you are restless. Let's sit together. Have peace with God. Even when you are restless, please get ready for any disappointment, because men will fail you. Men will disappoint you this year. But have peace with God. Hear me, people of God? Say to it today. Men will fail you. Men will disappoint you. The only person that cannot disappoint you in 2018 is God. Say to it right now. As I'm speaking to you now, right now. Look at the sister seated by you. Look at the brother seated by you. No matter how close, how good you are today, he or she will disappoint you. It's not may disappoint you. It's not that maybe he may. He will or she will. Only that they are in levels. What I mean? And somebody is saying, no, I cannot. Peter also said it to Jesus. He said, no, Jesus, you know me. Me. Is it Paul or Peter? He said, you know me. Me. I'm fond of you. I can't disappoint you. Jesus said, okay. I will soon test you very soon. Listen, it's a level. If you ask your friend now to give you 5 rand, and she told you, or he told you, I don't have 5 rand, my friend, it is difficult for you to believe. As far as you are concerned, he has disappointed you. And truly, you are disappointed. But truly speaking, you don't know what is in his mind or in his pocket. Man will disappoint. It's not a matter of, it's my chomi for life. We can't chomi for life. This one, they are chomi, they are labor for life. When rotation come now, this one can go and sit down here, this one come and sit down here. Things can change. At any time, anybody can disappoint. I can disappoint you. You can bring something to me, and you expect me to tell you what you want to hear. I might tell you what you don't want to hear. You may be disappointed and say, he's a bad pastor. He does not even see. He's not a prophet. I'm going to prophet Yanti. I can disappoint you. Men will disappoint you. But I have one person that will not disappoint you. Take all your heart desire. Take your fear. Take your peace to God Almighty. Finally, take a desperate decision this year. Number 12. Take a desperate decision this year. Because whatever gives you restless night must be put to rest today. I will follow Jesus. I will follow wherever he goes. I will follow. I will follow Jesus wherever he goes. I will follow. Rise upon your feet.